Hello guys, welcome to my channel Maths Pursuit. Today we are going to look into example 6 from chapter 5 called Arithmetic Progression. So let's see what exactly is given in example 6. Coming to example 6, it is given that check whether 301 is the term of the list of numbers 5, 11, 17, 23. That means we need to see if 301 is a term from among the given series. So let's see how we can solve this question. Now moving on to the solution. Let us put the given AP in the below table. As usual guys, I always prefer to create a table and put the given number sequence in that table so that it helps us in making our calculations without confusing among the numbers. So here I have created a 5 column table with 3 rows and naming first term to first cell, second term to second cell, third term to third cell, fourth term to fourth cell, and nth term to last cell. Because we don't know what exactly is that term, and we are going to find out that nth term. Now, putting 5 under first term, 11 under second term, 17 under third term, 23 under fourth term, and 301 under nth term. Here, guys, we are assuming 301 is a value of the nth term. But we don't know whether it is a value or not. We need to see. And giving A1 to first term, A2 to second term, A3 to third term, A4 to fourth term, and An to nth term. Guys, we are naming A1, A2, A3, A4, and An to the terms respectively, so that it will help us in making our calculation easily with the help of these A1, A2, A3, A4, An names. Now, here we need to find the value of n. The value of n should be a natural number only. That is, it should not be 0 or negative or in decimals. Guys, because we need to find if 301 is a value of among the given series, so we need to find out nth term. If n is a natural number, then only it satisfies the condition and we can ensure that, okay, 301 is a value. So let's see. Now we are going to find out common difference d. So here we are taking a2 minus a1. We can take any of the terms to find the common difference because in the question it is given that this is an AP. So just I'm taking here a2 minus a1. You can take a3 minus a2 or a4 minus a3. So now a2 minus a1 is equal to 11 minus 5. That is equal to 6. So we have now a1 is equal to 5. That means first term is 5, common difference is equal to 6, and an, that is equal to 30n, which is we have assumed that 301 is the value and we need to find n. Now using the formula, an is equal to a1 plus n minus 1 into d. So 301 is equal to 5 plus n minus 1 into 6. So putting the value, that means replacing the values in the above formula, we got like an is 301. So putting 301 is equal to a1 is 5 and n we don't know, and as per the formula it is minus 1 into 6. 6 is the common difference. Now solving this equation, we get 5 plus 6n minus 6 is equal to 301. So just reversing the equation so that it will be easy for finding the n here. And further solving the equation, we got 5 plus 6n minus 6 is equal to 301, or 6n is equal to 301 minus 5 plus 6, or 6n is equal to 302, or n is equal to 302 by 6, which is equal to 50.33. So guys, we found that the value of n is equal to 50.33. That means it does not fulfill the condition of a natural number. Yes, it does not fulfill the condition of a natural number, therefore it is not an term. So we can say that therefore, as n is not a natural number, hence 301 cannot be a term of the given list of numbers. Hope guys you understood this calculation, or you understood the way we tried to find out or identify if 301 is any value of the given term. Or any value of the term. If you still have any questions or confusions, kindly write to me in the comment section of this video. I will definitely get back to you once I see your comments. If you guys really like my video, kindly subscribe and share among your friends. This will motivate me to create similar type of videos in the future. Thank you. Bye.